Joseph Prince is well known for his "You are once righteous, always righteous" doctrine. John 10:28 is the key text of Joseph Prince in defending his "You are forever saved and you will never perish" doctrine.
Jesus said in John 10, look at this. Jesus said this in John 10, "My sheep hear my voice and I know them and they follow me." Are you his sheep? Have you believed in him? Do you believe he died for your sins on the cross? You believe he rose again from the dead to be your good shepherd, to watch over you, to love you? Amen. Then you are his sheep. And what did he say about his sheep? They follow me. I know them and they follow me. And I give them what? Eternal life. And they shall never perish. They shall never perish. What is it about never? We don't understand. And by the way, the never there is in the Greek double negative. Now, when you find a double negative, which is not all the time in the Greek New Testament, it's a powerful negation. It is not just no. It is never in any way. No, ever. You understand? You will never perish. Once you're born again, you will never perish. Jesus won't say his sheep will never perish. No, in no way perish. And another place, yeah, but if you do this, you'll perish. That's called schizo. And God is not like us. God means what he says.
In the other videos that I've personally viewed, Joseph Prince just told the audience about the promise in John 10:28 that we will never perish, and giving them the false idea that the promise comes with no conditions. He didn't tell them that there are conditions attached to the "you will never perish" promise in verse 28, which are found in the preceding verse, in verse 27, which I will cover in the ensuing discussion. In the video I've shown you just a while ago, Joseph Prince did try and supposedly cover verse 27. But he is pulling a wool of deception over your eyes by giving you the impression that he is expounding verse 27 in context, when in fact, he didn't. Tell me, was much of what Joseph Prince said in his quote reflected in verse 27? Nothing of what he said in his quote is reflected in verse 27. Verse 27 specifically says, "My sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me." What was said by Joseph Prince about believing in Christ, his death and resurrection, contain truths. But these truths are found in other contexts and not in the specific context of John 10, 27 to 28. Joseph Prince is merely reading what is true in other contexts into John 10, 27 to 28. He has again contravened the rule that the passage must be interpreted in its context. And he is not supposed to read something foreign, even though it may be true, into the text in question, which he did. All he's doing is that he is reading his pet doctrine of a belief only, justification only, and God loves you salvation doctrine into verse 27. And as I have said in a previous video, by reading into text, which he frequently does, anything can be proven by him. In context, the kind of sheep that will never perish in verse 28 is specifically listed down in verse 27 as sheep who hear or listen or obey Christ's voice and follow him, which he didn't expound at all. To fully understand John 10, 28, we must examine John 10, 27, which gives the context and the condition to John 10, 28. We must examine who these pronouns, them and they, in John 10, 28, are referring to in John 10, 27. From one quick reading, it becomes clear that the them and the they in verse 28 refer to those sheep who listen to Christ and follow him in verse 27. So now it's pretty clear that the promise of having eternal life and never perishing, and none can snatch you out of Christ's hands in verse 28, is not unconditional as Joseph the Prince has deceptively presented it to be. The promise in verse 28 that they shall never perish is conditional upon the sheep listening to Christ and following him in verse 27. To insist on the promise in verse 28, as Joseph Prince has done, without highlighting the condition in verse 27, is to distort Jesus' teaching. By now, you would have recognized that that's the usual deceptive strategy of Joseph Prince, of using a half-truth and pushing it as the whole truth to deceive the people of God. He tells you the half-truth about the promise in verse 28 without pointing out to you the other half-truth about the condition for the promise in verse 27. By doing that, he is deceiving believers that there is no condition, and that is being theologically dishonest. So it is very clear that the promise of having eternal life, never perishing, and none can snatch them out of God's hand in verse 28, is only to those sheep who listen and follow Christ in verse 27. To listen is simply to obey. If a mother confronts her son, "Boy, why didn't you listen to mom?" Is she saying, "Why didn't you tell me whether you heard what I said?" Of course not. She is saying, "Why didn't you do what I told you to?" Or, "Why didn't you obey my instructions?" In the same way, when we are listening to God, we are not saying to God that we heard what he has been saying to us, but we are saying, "God, I'm listening to every one of your instructions and to every one of your commands so I can obey them." Verse 27 clearly describes the type of person who will never perish as mentioned in verse 28. Christ said his sheep are listeners of his voice as obedient sheep whom he knows and who follow him. The word translated listen and follow in verse 27 is in the present indicative active in the Greek, which means that it is not just a one-time action, but it expresses continuous action. In other words, it is not just to listen or follow the shepherd once when you said the sinner's prayer 5 years ago, but are you continuing to listen and follow the shepherd by living out your salvation decision that you made 5 years ago on a regular basis? Only when we fulfill the condition of continuing to listen and continuing to follow the shepherd in verse 27 can we claim the promise in verse 28 that we will never perish. So the condition is not just obedience, but continual obedience. It is not just follow, but the continual following of Christ. Hence, the promise in verse 28 is not meant for sheep who are no more listening or no more following Jesus, but for those who are constantly in tune with Jesus, because they are constantly listening to Jesus and constantly obeying his instructions. It is not written for the backslider, but instead the obedient and faithful follower of Jesus Christ. To disregard the condition in John 10:27 is to twist the promise in John 10:28 out of its context and distort Jesus' teaching. That's what Joseph Prince has frequently and deceptively done. The promise of never perishing, as cited in verse 28, is not an unqualified one, nor does it apply in every single case, even for those who are not listening and following Christ. Next, I want to highlight the depth of what it means to follow Christ, which many may have missed. Let's peruse the following scriptures. The Greek word, as shown in green, and the English word follow in all of the passages is the same word that is used in John 10, 27. As you can see, following Jesus is often accompanied by the giving up of our everything and even our readiness to die for Christ. To follow Jesus is to pledge our total allegiance to Him as Master and Lord and to submit to every of His demands. Does Joseph Prince ever tell you that? He wouldn't, as he is dead against the biblical teaching about costly discipleship and costly grace that are taught by Jesus. He is against what Christ has so clearly taught, that anyone who wants to become His disciple must be prepared to give up everything, including his own life. So when Jesus made the promise of eternal life, about never perishing, and that no one can snatch you out of His hand in verse 28, it is for one who's listening or obeying and following Him in verse 27. If one isn't willing to continuously obey and continuously follow and give up everything for the sake of Christ in verse 27, the promise in verse 28 is not his to claim. I hope to impress upon you the truth in verse 27 that is very sobering. The issue is not only must we know Christ, but the most crucial issue is, does Christ know us? If we are listening to, obeying, and following Christ, Christ would know us. But if we are not obeying and following Christ, then Christ will not know us. If Christ does not know us, the promise of eternal life is not ours to claim. There are all kinds of sheep in the church. There are some so-called sheep who doesn't listen to or obey Christ. There are other so-called sheep who aren't prepared to follow Christ all the way. There are many sheep who are actually goats, but who have been self-deluded and deceived by Joseph Prince that they are sheep. But God's promise about not perishing in John 10, 28, is only for that kind of sheep who is listening to and following the Lord Jesus. As for sheep who are no longer listening or obeying and following Christ, in verse 28, the promise that they will never perish in verse 27 is not theirs to claim. But this is not what Joseph Prince teaches. He falsely teaches that the promise of never perishing has no conditions. Hence, he has deceived many who do not obey and follow the Lord Jesus with the false hope that they will never perish, even though they will. Such a deceiver who leads the multitudes to their eternal destruction can never be a Christ-centered preacher of God's word, but only a wolf in sheepskin.